गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, होप सो यू ऑल विल बी हेल्दी एंड गुड एट योर होम एंड विल टेक केयर ऑफ योर हेल्थ. सो स्टूडेंट, वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड 3 चैप्टर्स इन ज्योग्राफी एंड होप सो वट एवर द थिंग्स आई हैव बीन एक्सप्लेन टू यू, यू विल बी टेक केयर ऑफ ऑल द थिंग्स. सो टुडे स्टूडेंट, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ हिस्ट्री पोर्शन एंड यू कैन सी हियर द चैप्टर नंबर 1 इज़ गिवन हियर, वेयर, वेन एंड हाउ. Like the earlier classes in class 6, you have learnt about the ancient history till the death of Harshvardhana. Class 7th, you have studied about the medieval history till the Mughal period. And 8th standard, after the Mughal period, what the things had happened in our country and what were the reasons for the declining of Mughal Empire, that you have learnt in class 7th. And afterwards, what things took places in our country that and what the things still happen. It means still India is independent. It is considered the syllabus of 8th standard. So modern history you are learning in the class 8th. So student, we can understand here what the things you are going to learn first of all in the chapter. Here you can understand the time frame for modern history. So first of all, you will understand in this chapter what is the time frame for modern history. Afterwards, you will study major development in the modern period around the world. Then third point, you will study the new geographical categories during the modern period. And afterwards, not today but after topic, you will study about the sources for the study of modern history of India. So in each section, it means in each of the classes you are having the history, but for the each section you have gone through the different kinds of the sources to know the history. Like the classics, it is a different. For class 7th, you have learned the different sources, and class 8th you will come to know some of the different sources to know about your modern history. So let's start the chapter student. Today we can understand, first of all we'll understand by the timeline. What the timeline is explaining to you. So it is considering, first of all, after the death of Aurangzeb, when the Aurangzeb was died in 1707. But before that also in 1600 century, the East India Company was founded by the Britishers. Okay, and from that time only the sum of the period has been considered in the medieval period in Indian history. But after, it is totally considered after the death of Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb was the Mughal emperor and he was considered one of the most powerful Mughal emperor. But after his death, there were no mighty Mughal emperor who can unite all the Mughal empire in one knot. That's why slowly, slowly the things took places and you will study in the chapter. So soon afterwards you can understand here some of the date. It means that it is the important event of 1707 CE. Okay, 1707 CE, it means 1707 century is the one of the most important date when the year when Aurangzeb died, and afterward the things totally changed and turned in India. Okay, afterwards what the things is given here, we can understand here. The date is showing here 1757. 1757 century, it is the Battle of Plassey. Afterwards, 1857, it is the revolt of 1857. Battle of Plassey also one of the important incident in Indian history. This also you will come to know of in the second chapter. Then you can understand revolt of 1857. This is the important term related to the Indian freedom struggle. Okay, and it is known as the first independent struggle for Indian people. Okay, of the Indian people for the independence. Afterwards, we can understand 1947, India got freedom. So in this way, student, it is the some important, the time period is given here. Actually, this time period is explaining you, first of all, we have to look here 1707. It is the death of Aurangzeb. From here we have to consider the modern history in India. 1757, it is explaining the Battle of Plassey, because this is also the incident when one of the new history had been started in India. Afterwards, why the date is special date, it is putting here 1857. It is also one of the most important incident which had been turned so many things in our country. So that's why the date is also given here, and 1947 is given here. This also one of the most important period or the date which also changed the Indian history. So student, we have to be learn this all the fact by your timeline what the important incident is given here. So now student, we can start the chapter. First of all, what it is explaining to you. So in the class 7th, you have learned and understand about and classics. You have just gone through the ancient history and the medieval history. This class you are going to learn about the modern history. Okay, but student, according to our country and according to the fact, actually one thing you have to be understand how we are dividing the history. First of all, this question is there, how we are dividing the history. We are dividing the history some of the portions. It means when there is some social changes, we have to see the social changes. When there is a political changes, and when there is some economical changes, okay, and when there is some cultural changes. So each of the points, social changes, political changes, economical changes, and cultural changes. So student, whenever these things will get according to this all the points, on behalf of this the point, historians have divided Indian history the three portions. Student, you already have learned in the classics there is some changes, less changes in the ancient period. When medieval period came, the different kinds of the social, political, economical changes took place. Same thing from the 18th century, when the things had been changed, so there are also some different kinds of social, political, economical, and cultural changes in our country. So on behalf of this all the points, the historians are dividing the history. So this the date which is considering to divide our Indian history. This is not considered for whole country. For the example, we can understand here in Europe, as in a country, the modern history considered from the 18th century, but in the Europe, it has been started from the 16th century. Okay, so which was the most of the part of the medieval history in India? And you can understand, we have started the modern history from the 18th century, but it was started in the Europe from the 16th century. So after the important incident of death of Aurangzeb, considered the beginning of the modern period in India. Now, whatever the other things had happened throughout the world, we can understand here. Like modern period and overview. What the things had took place during the modern period in whole side of the world, and what are the important things we can understand here. So modern period and overview, it is explaining to you. First of all, student, you can understand it is the one word is given here, secular European Renaissance. Okay, Renaissance means the one of the period when there is some emphasis on the some kinds of the revival. It means that is the field of the music, painting, sculpture, theater, literature, and science. Okay, so it is known as a revival. Renaissance means when there is some kinds of the awareness among the people. It is the time period when the people have given the humanism. Humanism means when more important to the human being in the comparison of the other things. Along with this one, they have given the importance to the music, painting, sculpture, theater, literature, and the science related to the humanism, related to the human being. So you have to understand, during the modern period from the 15th, 16th century, the Renaissance which took place in the European country was a great impact for the whole world. There were the development in different fields. Just we have talked here, music, painting, sculpture, theater, literature, and the science. Afterwards, when what the things had happened or took place the whole world, we can understand here, 1453, when the troops, earlier the different Europeans were taking the place, they were having the road to move from the eastern country here and there. But what happened? the Turks they control over these routes. That's why the European have to search some other routes for the East countries. It means earlier the only the Europeans were using the East country the path for the different countries, but the 1453 when the Turks took control for these routes, so for the European have to search another route. Why this point came here? Because from this route only the European succeed to search another route for the Europe, for the Asian countries. Now next point we are going to learn this point only. Now it is given here. So the point is explaining you the zest for adventure initiated by the movement called Renaissance also increased long sea voyages. It means just we have talked about the Renaissance. It means this period has given the special treatment to the literature field, music, art, painting. But not only this much field. This Renaissance also given the some kinds of the adventurous people. Who are the adventurous people? They were the different kinds of the adventurous people like the Magellan, Christopher Columbus, Vasco da Gama. They were the Spanish and the Portuguese explorers. Explorers mean those who are searching the things which is they have to discover some new routes and new things. They are known as explorers. So it's, they were the Spanish and the Portuguese, and like the names already we are aware here. Okay, Christopher Columbus, Magellan and Vasco da Gama, they were the explorer. And by the period of Renaissance, they got some kinds of the adventurers to search and to explore the long sea voyages. That's why Vasco da Gama succeed to come to the across the Indian subcontinent, and then the Portuguese succeed to come the Asian countries. We also will read and study in the further topics. So student, in this way you have to understand during the Renaissance period the people not only got the succession and succeed in the different fields, but they also got some kinds of new sea routes to move their different Asian countries for their long sea journeys and for the new adventurers. Now what things happen after discovery the sea routes? Only the people got the some kinds of the trade contact. Not only they have got the trade contact, now not only they have studied the business with the different countries, but also there was the emergence of the imperialism. What is the meaning of imperialism? It means a system where a powerful country is controlling over a less powerful countries. So by the exploration of the sea routes, not only the business and trade system has been started, but also there was an imperialism system also had been started. Like the different, we know about our country, like how the British people, they started the imperialism of Indian people. It means they were more powerful. It is not totally true, they were more powerful. Actually, we are not united that time. That's why, okay, they have control over us for almost 200-300 years here. So in this way, student, what are different points we have learnt here? Next point, this is explained to you new geographical categories. It means how the different kinds of the things took place. In the geographical wise also, how the things has been starting in a country. Not only the India, but the taking the whole world also. Okay, first of all, industrial revolution is given here in the second paragraph. Industrial revolution. Student, before that, the people are not making all the things like this way. It means like the home, cottage and the small things they are making. But first of all, the industrial revolution, when it first took place in the England, in the mid 18th century, so it is also one kind of the new Renaissance period for the whole world. So when the industrial revolution had been started, so the England people, they demand the raw materials. And the demand for the new material only have done some kinds of the inventions, some such as the steam engine, power loom and the cotton gun. So in this way they have started different kinds of the inventions. Because for the industry, we know industrial revolution means the industry which is producing different kinds of things. If the industry is established one time, so we need different kinds of the machines and the tools. First of all, they have started different kinds of inventions. Okay. Second thing, now they need the some kinds of the raw and the cheap materials, which they were not getting in their country, but they have to go for search in another countries. Okay, so that's why student, we can understand here, this is the main point what I am going to explain to you. For the raw material only, they have, the British people came to our country to search the raw materials. Okay, so it is given here student in the second point. Through voyages of discovery, European go to know about the vast area all over the world, which could provide them with cheap raw material, labor, besides servicing as market for their finished product. So what the point, it is an important point you have to understand. By the industrial revolution, first of all, they have invented the different kinds of machine. Second, by the industrial revolution, they have to search the different kind of cheap materials all over the world. And not only this one, beside this one, they have to search the labor and the servicing market and finished product where they can sell their things. Okay, so in this way student, you can understand what the things took place during the starting of the modern period throughout the world. In this way, we can understand the race for capturing these new unexplored area resulted the establishment of various colonies of European power in different parts of the whole world. Okay, it means it is the explanation of this point only. If you understood first point, it is the explanation of second and then third also same thing. It is a correlation. That's why the second and first, third point is given here. So why this? That's why when these countries started to move throughout the world, so now they started the process of imperialism. They started to capture the weak countries for their advantages, for their own selfishness. Okay student, so that's why new geographical area emerged. It means different new countries. You know, India also searched afterwards only when Vasco da Gama came here. Same way when the Christopher Columbus reached to the America. So the British people, they got the new land, new countries for them. Before that, the people only heard about, okay, the India was in the one of the Asian countries, which is known as a different name, Bharatvarsh, Aryan, Aryavrat, and different names. But when the Indian came in the country, then only they have given the name in the India. Okay, so student, it is the explanation how the different things took place the whole world. And through this map, you can understand how the things had been started. Okay, like it is showing the America here. Okay, the second, it is showing the Europe, Middle East, and here Asia and the Far East. Afterwards, we can understand here Africa, and here the different other, Australia and the other. So slowly the British people, they started to explore all these continents, which were the continents were best for them and where they were getting the raw material, other things, so they were capturing. So student, in this way you can understand what the things is given here. It means how the modern history in India started in a country and how the different things took place. What is the meaning of Renaissance and how the new geographical categories has been started, this also we have learned. Hope so you will go through. Okay, this is explaining to you the modern period in Europe, this also we have explained to you. The Renaissance period, how this, what is the meaning of Renaissance, this also we have talked here. Okay, in this way the Industrial Revolution, this also during the mid 18th century I have explained to you. This also we have learnt here. Okay, afterwards student, today you have to fill the exercise what is given in your book. And the first chapter, it means the introduction of the chapter, it is given the timeline, that also you have to draw in your history notebook. Okay, so hope so whatever today you have learned you will go through. If you are not understanding any point something, so we can understand afterwards. So till then, have a nice day.